In today's video, I am going to explain important muscle anatomy for yoga pose. Today's pose is downward dog. Downward dog. I am going to focus on lower extremity and upper extremity anatomy. In first part, I want to focus on lower extremity, particularly around backside of lower extremity. If this part is tight, it's hard to get good length on backside of body. Let me explain lower extremity first. Okay, this is back of body, back of lower extremity. If this part is tight, it's gonna be hard to do downward dog. Where is that particularly? Let's say like Achilles tendon. Achilles tendon, gastrocnemius, hamstrings, and butt muscle, particularly gluteus maximus. You know, they are all on posterior part of body, right? So if either one of place gets tight, that may aggravate good stretching effect for lower extremity. Let's focus on Achilles tendon and gastrocnemius. If this part is tight, it's hard to keep your heel on ground. See, this person is a little bit, you know, heel off. So if gastrocnemius and Achilles tendon is tight, it's kind of bring ankle joint to plantar flexion. That means if this part is tight, it's gonna be hard to do dorsiflexion. Dorsiflexion in this case is heel is on ground. See that? And if hamstring is tight, it's gonna be hard to keep knee straight, because function of hamstrings is flexion of knee, that bends knee joint. If that gets tight, the muscle brings knee to flexion. It's gonna be hard to keep knee joint straight. Does it make sense? Then what's gonna happen if your butt muscle is tight? Now it's same thing. It's hard to keep this good length. See that? Posterior part flexibility is important for downward dog position. Plus, there is myofascial connection from calcaneus, gastrocnemius, hamstrings, and lower back. So you can say there's one continuation from foot, calf, thigh, and lower back. So if one of this place gets tight, let's say if your hamstrings is tight, maybe this tightness can affect gastrocnemius, Achilles tendon, or even for lower back. Thus, this myofascial connection idea is important to understand for stretching, for exercise, for many things. Anyhow, lower extremity, posterior part, is important for downward dog pose. Now let's go to upper extremity. I want to focus around shoulder joint and lateral part of body. This is posterior view of shoulder joint. I want to focus on this part, posterior part of axilla. See, there is so many muscles around posterior axilla. Actually, I explained detailed anatomy for Warrior One pose, so I'm not gonna explain too much detail about this place. So if you wanna know more detail, please check Warrior One video. Anyhow, so many muscles are around posterior part of axilla. What happens if this part is tight? One tendency is it's hard to bring your shoulder vertically. Okay, if this part gets tight, tendency is your shoulder kind of opens up. Plus, it's hard to keep this vertical position. See, her core and arms are kind of vertical. It's in line, right? If the axilla is tight, tendency is shoulders go forward. You can't keep good horizon, vertical, inline position. Thus, this posterior axilla is important to keep shoulder position. Okay? Now let's go to the other muscle. This is the muscle. This is serratus anterior. Serratus anterior attaches on scapula and ribcage. This muscle is so important for stabilization of scapula. Stabilization of scapula. Why is that important for downward dog? So not only for downward dog. If your hands are on ground, you need to stabilize your hand, upper extremity, right? Of course. Then why is scapula involved? Why is serratus anterior involved? Okay, because scapula is kind of base of upper extremity. Because humerus, your shoulder is from scapula. Okay, again, here is scapula. Your humerus is from scapula. Huh. Then your forearm attaches to humerus. And your forearm becomes to hand. So scapula is like base of upper extremity. If your scapula is not well stabilized, what's going to happen? Maybe your hands lose stability. Then what if your serratus anterior is tight, your scapula doesn't move, it's not well stabilized, then what's going to happen? Maybe your hands lack stability. That is why serratus anterior is important, that the hands on position. It's like downward dog position or like maybe push up position. Any poses that requires hands are on ground, serratus anterior and scapula are so important. Of course, posterior axilla is equally important. One more thing. Serratus anterior is also important for shoulder movement. Shoulder movement, okay? Here is scapula. Again, humerus and scapula is connected. Then if scapula doesn't move, your shoulder, your humerus doesn't move, these two places must move together. Then what is function of serratus anterior? Stability. Plus, of course, serratus anterior moves scapula. If serratus anterior is tight, that lacks both mobility and stability. If scapula lacks mobility, shoulder joint lacks mobility, then what can you say for downward dog position? If scapula lacks stability, your hands lack stability. If scapula lacks mobility, it's going to be hard to move your upper extremity. Thus, serratus anterior and scapula are freaking important for downward dog position. So in this video, I explained two places that are important for downward dog pose. One place is posterior part of lower extremity. If either part gets tight, you will get tight place here. Then next place is upper extremity, axilla and scapula serratus anterior. I hope this video gives tip to improve your yoga practice. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment and subscribe. See you next video.